Right, what's going on? Welcome to We Got a Problem. So we had the first round of votes for the next Tory party leader and Prime Minister of this country earlier today. Now, I'm no fan of the Conservative Party. They spent the last 3 years trying to make us the vassal state of Europe. But we need them to get us out of the communist EU and prevent Commissar Corbynov from becoming the next Prime Minister. Now, obviously Boris won, and he won by 71 votes over his next closest rival.
Jeremy Hunt.
So this vote means that the leadership contenders have now been whittled down to seven, losing Esther McVeigh, Andrea Leadsom and Mark Harper. Now let's take a look at the vote before we look at the actual point of this video, which is what one of the contenders who are still in the running said.
The total number of votes cast for each candidate in alphabetical order were as follows. Michael Gove, 37. Matt Hancock, 20. Mark Harper, 10. Jeremy Hunt, 43. Sajid Javid, 23. Boris Johnson, 114. Andrea Leadsom, 11. Esther McVeigh, 9. Dominic Raab, 27. And Rory Stewart, 19. Therefore, the following seven candidates are eligible to participate in the next ballot on Tuesday, the 18th of June. Michael Gove, Matt Hancock, Jeremy Hunt, Sajid Javid, Boris Johnson, Dominic Raab, and Rory Stewart. And on your behalf, can I thank my colleagues for participating in an orderly election, and my colleague officers of the 1922 and our staff for helping conduct the ballot in an orderly fashion today. Thank you.
So as I said, Boris won comfortably, but that is likely going to be a surprise to no one at all. Andrea Leadsom, Mark Harper and Esther McVeigh got kicked to the curb, but the thing I want to focus on is someone who made it through, because it seems we have a shit weasel that got called out by Andrew Neil on the Politics Live show. Let's watch.
Were you surprised that you got through to the second round?
I'm completely over the moon. As you know, I had six declared votes, and more than three times that number of colleagues voted for me in that secret ballot. And I think probably what changed it, Andrew, this morning is that we've had the first polls out from Conholm showing that I'm now second amongst the Conservative members. The challenge until now has been that we were able to show that I was outpolling the other candidates or neck and neck with Boris amongst the public, and the comeback was always, but what about the members? This morning we finally had the poll showing that I'm second amongst the members, and I think that must have been what turned around those final few.
Where do you get your votes from now in the second round? To whom do you appeal to get a lot more than you're through, but you've not got a lot of votes? How do you build on that?
You build on that, Andrew, I'm afraid, by just saying this message that I'm selling, which is about being radical, about being brave in the centre ground, by getting out and listening to people, is extraordinarily popular. None of these other candidates at the moment are really tapping into this, but at the moment I think I've got 57 million social media impressions. I can put out a video on something like National Citizen Service, get 1.4 million people watching. What I'm discovering is that a conservative message communicated properly, and if you listen in the right way, is incredibly popular, and that's what I have to get across to colleagues.
Now, I think it could be said that if the electorate was Twitter, you might have won.
But if the electorate was Twitter, that's true. But it's also true in the opinion polls, Andrew. So if you see the Observer polls, if you see the YouGov polls, I'm now either neck and neck with Boris or just behind him. And that's a huge change just in 2 weeks.
But there is huge suspicion among MPs and among many in the party in the country that you are just too much of a Remainer to deliver Brexit.
Well, Andrew, the key thing is this. I voted Remain, but I have been passionately committed to getting Brexit through. You hopefully will have seen me on every television screen in the country for the last few months arguing to get this deal through, and I'm a realist. The reason that I can get Brexit done more quickly than the other candidates is that I recognise that at the heart of this is Parliament. These other candidates are often just saying, I'm going to get Brexit done. But when you say to Boris, how are you going to get Brexit done? Are you going to lock the doors of Parliament? Are you going to get some new deal from Europe? No answer really comes back. So what we really need to get to, the way I'm going to win this race, is to get people to focus on the practical issues. How do we get this done?
Do you intend to reopen the negotiations if you were to win?
I would look at the political declaration, and I was talking to the German ambassador recently, I'd be on the plane immediately talking to Chancellor Merkel and others about that. But there is absolutely no way at all that Europe is going to allow the withdrawal agreement to be rewritten any time this year. So if we want to leave the European Union, the way to do it is to get that extra 45 votes in Parliament and drive it through. And the key thing, Andrew, imagine that I did get elected. I would be coming in with a completely different mandate from Theresa May. I would be coming in having won an election, openly saying to members of the Conservative Party, I am going to get the withdrawal agreement through. And that would give me a very, very different position in relation to Steve Baker, Andrew Rossendale, John Redwood, who've been saying up till now that the members do not want to do Brexit in that way.
Right. Now, you may have another mandate. That would remain to be seen. But from what you say, a vote for Rory Stewart would be a vote for Mrs. May's withdrawal agreement.
A vote for Rory Stewart is a vote for getting Brexit done as quickly as it can be done and unlocking the opportunities.
On the May agreement.
Unlocking the opportunities. On the withdrawal agreement,
yes.
Negotiated with Europe. Exactly.
Which is the May agreement.
The same agreement, Andrew, that the Prime Minister negotiated and our civil servants negotiated. That is the agreement.
That's it.
The only agreement.
So you are continuity May.
I'm not continuity May. I don't look anything like the previous Prime Minister. I negotiate in a completely different way.
Your agreement looks a lot like her agreement.
Because, Andrew, it's the reality. It's the only agreement. There are no other agreements out there. All these other candidates are spinning fairy stories and fantasies. Where are their agreements? Where are their deals?
So there you have it. Rory the soy boy Stewart wants to sell us down the same road as Theresa the EU appeaser tried to. He wants to use her deal and push it through Parliament like that will get him anywhere with the voters. He even stood there boasting about his 57 million impressions on Twitter and the support he has on there, forgetting that no one gives a fuck about how big you are on Twitter. The UK public are not all on Twitter to use it as a gauge to be the next Prime Minister. Most of the Twitter support is from the blue checkmark lefties and their followers around the world. Plus 57 million impressions is not that special. My channel has been going for just over a month and I have nearly 20 million impressions without your public position or press attention. And views or popularity on Twitter will not make you the next Prime Minister, as I've already said. Now this soy boy is completely delusional, thinking he stands a chance. The distance Boris won by shows that Brexiteers have had enough and will not accept this Ramoning communist within the Conservative Party. Rory Stewart has earned his first nomination for Shitweasel of the Week with this performance, the snivelling fuckpig. He is Theresa May 2.0, although she probably has a bigger dick than this toad-looking soy boy. Now I'm going to end the video there, it was just a quick one about what happened earlier. So it seems that there's still at least one communist traitor in the race to be the next Prime Minister. Let me know what you think about Rory and his attempts to make us the vassal state of Europe like Theresa May did. Now don't forget to subscribe, like and share the video, and I will see you all in the next one.